Hi friends, in this session I am going to talk about the sources of return in a fixed rate bond. In a fixed rate bond, the sources of return are generally coupon amount, then the principal amount, then the reinvestment amount when the coupon amount is reinvested somewhere else, and then the capital gain, which I'll talk about later. Okay, and these are basically based on five assumptions. The first is, suppose a bond is held till maturity, then the rate of return to the investor in this case is equal to the yield to maturity. In the second case, if the bond is sold prior to its maturity, then the rate of return to the investor will be also yield to maturity if the yield to maturity during the sale is equal to when it was purchased. Okay. Third assumption is that suppose the market yield to maturity, which is our assumed reinvestment rate, suppose it increases. Okay. Suppose it increases, then the rate of return to the investor in this case will be greater than the yield to maturity. Okay, suppose in the fourth assumption, suppose the market yield to maturity, which is our assumed reinvestment rate, suppose it increases, and then the rate of return to the investor, like before the first coupon date, it will be lesser than the yield to maturity if the bond is for a short duration. Okay, and the fifth assumption is that suppose the market yield to maturity or our assumed reinvestment rate, suppose it decreases. Okay, suppose it decreases, then post the bonds purchase, of course, then the rate of return to the investor in this case will be lower than the yield to maturity if the tenure of the bond is for a longer duration. So these are the five basic assumptions involved in this sources of return. Okay, then I'll talk about few of the concepts which are involved in this. First is the annualized holding period return. Okay, this is the compound annualized return that investor receives, and the value of it depends on the coupon amount, the principal amount, and the reinvestment amount. Okay, and the next is the investment horizon is the period for which the bond lies with the investor. Then the carry value is the bond's value, the purchase and the sale value at the when the yield to maturity is the same, that is the carry value of the bond. Okay, and next is the capital gain. Suppose when a bond is sold prior to maturity, if it is sold at a higher price than the purchased, then it is said to be a capital gain. If it is lesser than the purchase price, then it is said to be a capital loss. Then we'll see the market price risk and the reinvestment risk. Market price risk, when it comes, suppose a bond is for a shorter duration, let's say it for a 1 year. Okay, when it is sold just before one year, then there will not be any coupon payment or interest rate risk will be there. So here the interest rate risk will be higher than the reinvestment risk, because if the bond can be reinvested elsewhere after the selling, and if the bond is kept for a longer duration, then here there will be the reinvestment risk will be higher than the market rate risk. So these are the concepts that are there or involved in the in a fixed rate bond, and also we see generally come across while calculating the rate of return in a fixed rate bond. Thank you very much for watching this session, and in the next session we will talk about the various duration, like Maculay's duration, effective duration associated with a bond. Thank you very much.